Hello students, we are discussing about residential status. In the previous sessions we discussed about residential status and computation of residential status of an individual. In this session onwards, let us discuss about incidence of tax liability under section 5. Incidence of tax liability means situations where an assessee is liable to pay tax. Incidence of tax depends upon residential status of an individual and also on the place and time of accrual or receipt of income as shown below. Incidence of tax is depending upon the residential status of an individual, whether he is an ordinary resident, not ordinarily resident or non-resident, and time and place, whether that income is accrued or received in the previous year or not, and place, accrued or received in India or not. On that basis, this incidence of tax liability is calculated. Let us see the tax liability of an ordinary resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident in this session. First, let us start with ordinary resident. Ordinarily resident in India is assessable to tax in respect of income which, first one, is received or deemed to be received in India in the previous year by him or on behalf of such person, whether accrued or arose anywhere. Here, ordinary resident is liable to pay tax in the following situations. First situation is, income is received or deemed to be received in India by him and that income is accrued or arose in India or outside India. He is receiving income in India, that income may be accrued in India or outside India. That is the first situation. Second one, accrues or arises or is deemed to accrue or arise to him in India during such year, whether received anywhere. In the first case, received in India. In this case, received anywhere, that may be in India or outside India, but accrued or accrues in India. So that is the second situation. See the difference here. In first case, received in India but accrued anywhere. In the second case, accrued in India but received anywhere. That is the difference between two situations here. Next, third one, accrues to him outside India during such year. That means income accrues to him outside India during the previous year. For these incomes, ordinary resident must pay tax in the current assessment year. What are the cases here? Received or deemed to be received in India, income accrued or arising in India or outside India. Second one, accrues or arises in India but receiving anywhere, that is in India or outside India. And third one, accrues to him outside India during the year. That is the three situations where ordinary resident must pay tax. Next is not ordinarily resident. When not ordinarily resident person must pay tax in India. The situations are similar to both ordinary resident and not ordinarily resident. See, the first one, income is received or deemed to be received in India in the previous year by him or on behalf of such person, whether accrued or arose anywhere. That is, income is received in India but accrues in India or outside India. Second one, accrues or arises or is deemed to accrue or arise to him in India during such year, whether received anywhere. See, these two cases are same to both ordinary resident and not ordinarily resident. The second situation is accrues or arises or deemed to accrue in India but received anywhere, that may be in India or outside India. These two cases are same, but see the last one, accrues or arise to him outside India from a business controlled in or a profession set up in India. In case of ordinary resident, accrues outside India is taxable, but in case of not ordinary resident, if that business is wholly or partly controlled in India or a profession set up in India, only for that type of income, if he receives that type of income outside India, that is taxable in India. So that is the difference. For ordinarily resident, any income received outside India taxable in India, but in case of ordinarily, not ordinarily resident, only if that business or profession is set up in India, only that type of income accrued outside India is taxable in India. So see the difference here. First two cases similar to both ordinarily resident and not ordinarily resident, and third case there is slight difference. You have to compare that the difference here. Next, let us see what are the situations where non-resident must pay tax in India. Non-resident in India is assessable to tax in respect of income which is received or deemed to be received in India in the previous year by or on behalf of such person, whether accrued or arose anywhere. Here, income received or deemed to be received in India in previous year by him or on behalf of him by any other person, whether accrued or arose anywhere. Received in India but accrued anywhere, that is in India or outside India. Second one, accrues or arises or is deemed to accrue or arises to him in India during such year, whether received anywhere, that is accrued in India but received in India or outside India. These two situations, under these two situations, non-resident must pay tax in India. Very simple. Here, if income is received in India or accrued in India, they have to pay tax in India. Okay, here we are using the terms accrued, deemed to accrue, etc. Here you must know what is the meaning of that accrued income or deemed to accrued or deemed to receive income. Let us discuss the meaning of that here. First one, deemed to be received. Income has not actually been received but is deemed to be received under the Income Tax Act is known as deemed to be received income. That is, here income not actually received here. They are yet to receive that income in future. That type of income is known as deemed to be received. Here they have to pay tax for that income also, because they know that they are going to receive that income in future in that year. That is fixed here. Because of that reason, they have to pay tax. Here, example for deemed to be received income is annual accretion to the provident fund, that is annual increase in the provident fund, that may be in terms of interest, etc. Next one, dividend declared but not received in the same year, that is dividend declared for the year but it is not received in the same year, but they will receive that dividend in the next year. but that dividend is relating to the previous year. That type of dividend they have to tax in the previous year itself, because it is already declared but not received, but they will receive that dividend in the next year for the previous year. That type of income is known as deemed to be received, which is already declared or already accrued, but they are yet to receive that income in the next year. Next term is income accrued. What do you mean by that? Income is said to be received when it is reaches the SSC. Before reaching the SSC, we cannot say income received. When the right to receive the income becomes vested in the SSC, it is said to accrue or arise. That means income already accrued or income already declared, but it is not yet received here. That is known as income accrued. For example, interest accrued on a mutual fund or interest accrued on your fixed deposit, etc. It is automatically received every year. Okay, here if you receive that income every year or in a fixed term, that is accrued, but here it is not necessarily received by you or received by the SSC, is known as income accrued. Next one is deemed to accrue or arise. It is nothing but it is yet to accrue, not yet accrued or not yet declared by anyone or not yet deposited to your account by anyone, but it is yet to deposit to your account or it is yet to given to you in the future. Section 9 provides that certain incomes are deemed to accrue or arise in India even if they actually accrue or arise outside India. This section applies to all SSCs irrespective of their residential status, nationality, domicile or place of business. In some cases, if the income is received or accrued outside India, we have to consider it as received or accrued in India. Which are such incomes? Let us see. First one, income from business connection in India. Any business which is in connection with India, if you earn any income relating to that business outside India, you have to consider it as income of India. Next one, income from any property, asset or source of income in India. Next one, capital gain on transfer of a capital asset situated in India. Any capital gain from capital asset which is in India, if you receive income from that even if outside India, you have to consider it in received in India because that type of asset is situated in India. Next one, income from salary if services is rendered in India. If you are outside India and receive income outside India for the services you are rendering to India, that is known as income earned in India. Next one, dividend paid by the Indian company. Next one, income from salaries if it is earned in India. Next one, salary payable abroad by the government to a citizen of India in respect of his services he is rendering to India. For example, if anyone is serving in any government department outside India, for his service he'll receive income outside India, but he is citizen of India and he is serving India, because of that reason his income is considered as income of India. So these are the cases where deemed to be accrue or arise income in outside India is considered as income accrued in India. Next, Let us see the incidence of tax for different taxpayers. That means when different taxpayers must pay tax in India. Types of tax given, types of income is given, that is Indian income and foreign income, and resident and ordinary resident, resident but not ordinarily resident, and non-resident are given. Here, for which kind of income they have to pay tax in India, that you have to study. See the first one here. Resident and ordinary resident of India. For Indian income, they have to pay tax, and also for foreign income, they have to pay tax in India because they are resident of India. Second one, non-resident, not ordinarily resident of India. They have to pay tax for the income they earned in India, and they are not supposed to pay tax for foreign income. But they have to pay tax for foreign income in some cases. They are business or profession income, and business or profession is controlled wholly or partly from India or set up in India respectively. That means if the business and profession or business or profession set up in India wholly or partly or controlled in India, for that type of foreign income they have to pay tax. That you already learnt. Next, see non-resident. Non-resident must pay tax for the income which he earned in India, taxable in India for Indian income only, and foreign income is not taxable in India because he is a non-resident and he can earn income outside India, that is not relating to India. So no need to pay tax. Next, see the following table states the incidence of tax on income of individual and HUF. Here these are the situations or particulars of income. You have to study who and all have to pay tax on these items of income. That is ordinary resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident. Whether they have to pay tax or not, you have to study. See the first one, income received in India, whether accrued in India or outside India. Here you have to remember one thing, ordinary resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident, it is compulsory for them to pay tax on the income they earned in India. Here for ordinarily resident, they have to pay tax on income earned in India or outside India. But not ordinarily resident, they have to pay tax on the income they earned in India, but there is exception for the payment of tax that they earned income outside India. That is if only if the business or profession situated or controlled in India, they have to pay tax. If they are earning income from any foreign company, no need to pay tax in India. For a non-resident, they have to pay tax only on the income they earned in India. You have to remember this much. And now you see these items. First one, income received in India. See, received in India, whether accrued in India or outside India, all three parties must pay tax because it is received in India. Next, see, income deemed to be received in India, whether accrued in India or outside India. Income yet to receive in India, all three parties have to pay tax. Next, see, income accruing or arising in India. See, in India term is there, whether received in India or outside India, all three parties have to pay tax. Next one, income deemed to accrue or arise in India, whether received in India or outside India, they have to pay tax, all three parties. Next, see, income received and accrued outside India from a business controlled in a profession set up in India. See here, income received and accrued outside India but controlled in India. Ordinary SSC have to pay tax, not ordinarily resident have to pay tax, but non-resident need not pay tax because it is received by him outside India. Next, see, income received and accrued outside India from a business controlled from outside India or profession set up outside India. Here, income received outside India and controlled outside India, that is wholly income is from outside India. Ordinarily resident must pay the tax because he is an ordinary resident of India and receive it is his income. Not ordinarily resident, no need to pay tax because it is not controlled in India, and non-resident need not pay tax because it is not relating to India. Next, last one, income earned and received outside India but later on remitted to India. No parties have to pay tax because it is earned but not remitted to India in this previous year. No one has to have to pay tax here. Note, yes means taxable in India and no means not taxable in India. So this is about incidence of tax liability of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident. In the next session, let us solve some illustrations relating to this incidence of tax liabilities. Thank you. Let us meet in the next session.